Hello class 8, welcome to your computer online classes. Students, today we will continue our chapter number 4, program coding. In my previous video, I have explained you the object-oriented programming and the features of object-oriented programming. In this video, I will explain you the compiler, interpreter, machine code, object code, etc. First, I am telling you about the compiler. Compiler is a computer program that transforms code written in high-level language, because we are writing our course in high-level language, means we are writing our course in English language, that is known as high-level language, into the machine code. That compiler that converts that high-level language code into machine code, because computer understand only machine code. It will not understand the high level language coding. It is a program which translates the human readable code, means the English language code, to a language a computer processor understands, because computer understands only machine codes, that is the binary bits, binary numbers, zeros and ones. Zeros means off and ones means on. The computer processor, the machine code to perform the corresponding task. A compiler should come completely with the syntax rule of that programming language in which it is written. However, the compiler is only a program and cannot fix error found in the programs. So, if you make a mistake, you need to make changes in the syntax of your program. Otherwise, it will not compile. Compile means run. That program will not compile or that program will not run. Now, role of compiler. What is the role of compiler? Compiler reads the source code, outputs executable code. First, it will read the source code. What is the source code? The source code, the high level language code is known as the source code. So, compiler reads that source code, then translates software written in a higher level language into instruction that computer can understand. It converts the text that a programmer writes, programmer means we, a programmer writes into a format at the CPU can understand. Now, it translates the language which the programmer writes in that machine code which the CPU understand. Now, the process of completion is relatively complicated. It spends a lot of time analyzing and processing the program. The executable results is some form of machine specific binary code. Now, this is the role of compiler. Now, next is interpreter. Interpreter is also a program, computer program, which converts each high level language, programming language statement into the machine code. Same way, compiler is also doing this work and interpreter is also doing this work. This includes source code, pre-compiled code and scripts. Both compiler and interpreter show the same job, which is converting high level programming into machine code. However, a compiler will convert the code. Only difference is this: compiler will convert the code into machine code before program run, but interpreter converts code into machine code when the program is run. Means compiler can convert the program, whole program, before program run on the system, but interpreter converts the code when the program is running. Role of interpreter. The interpreter converts the source code line by line during runtime. When program is running, that time interpreter converts the source code line by line. First, it will convert first line, after that second line, then third line, then fourth line. Rest of line converted in this form. Now, interpreter completely translates a program written in a high level language into machine level language. It will completely translates. Interpreter allows evolution and modification of the program while it is executing. Means we can change any statement, we can change the error, which mistakes which are showing in the program at that program running. Relatively less time spent for analyzing and processing the program. It will take less time. Program execution is relatively slow compared to compiler. Compiler execution is taking so much time, but in this is slow compared to compiler. Now, difference between compiler and interpreter. Compiler, first compiler creates the program. It will create the program. Compile will parse or analyze all the language statement and for its correctness. If correct, through an error means it will compile, it will convert complete program in one go. If no error, the compiler will convert source code to machine code. If there is no error, then it will convert complete program into machine code. It links different code files into a runnable program known as .exe, executable file. Run the program. Now, interpreter. It also create the program. No linking of files or of machine code generation. It will not link with any other file. Source statement executed line by line during the running of the program. Now, advantages and disadvantages of both. The advantages: the program code is already translated into machine code, thus it code execution time is less. Interpreter are easier to use, especially for beginners. Disadvantage: you cannot change the program without going back to the source code. In compiler we can change, but here we cannot change. Interpreted programs can run on computer that have the corresponding interpreter. Machine code store machine language as machine code on the disk, not saving machine code at all. Now key difference. These are the difference. Now key differences. Compiler transforms code written in high level programming language into the machine code at once. In once it will change complete program into machine code before programs run. Whereas the interpreter converts each high level programming statement one by one, line by line, into the machine code during during program run. Means the difference is compiler converts complete program before program run, but interpreter convert the program line by line during program run. Second difference: compiled code runs faster while interpreted code runs slower. Means compiler take less time, but interpreter take much time as compared to compiler. Compiler displays all error after completion. On other hand, interpreter displays error of each line one by one. Compiler is based on translation linking loading model, whereas interpreter is based on interpretation methods. Compiler takes an entire program, whereas the interpreter takes a single line of code. Means compiler takes complete program for converts into machine code, but interpreter takes a line by line, one line, two line, one line, then second line, then third line. Now, high level language, the source code. What is the source code? The code which are written in high level language, that is known as source code. High level languages like C, C++, Java, etc. are very near to English. It makes programming process easy. However, it must be translated into machine language before execution. Execution means running the program. This translation process is either conducted by a compiler or an interpreter. So these codes which are written in readable form, that are known as the source code. This is the definition of source code. We can say that the high level languages code is also known as the source code. Then machine code. Machine languages are very close to the hardware. Every computer has its machine language. A machine language programs are made up of series of binary patterns, like example 110110. These are the binary pattern. The machine language write their code in this pattern. It represents the simple operation which should be performed by. So मशीन लैंग्वेज प्रोग्राम्स आर एग्जीक्यूटेबल सो दैट दे कैन बी रन डायरेक्टली. ऑब्जेक्ट कोड. ऑन कंप्लीशन ऑफ सोर्स कोड द मशीन कोड जनरेटेड फॉर डिफरेंट प्रोसेसर लाइक इंटेल एएमडी एंड एआरएम इन डिफरेंट फॉर्म. टू मेक कोड पोर्टेबल द सोर्स कोड इज फर्स्ट कन्वर्टेड टू ऑब्जेक्ट कोड. इट इज एन इमीडिएटली कोड सिमिलर टू मशीन कोड. ऑब्जेक्ट कोड इज ऑल्सो नोन इट इज ऑब्जेक्ट कोड इज ऑल्सो नोन एज इंटरमीडिएटरी कोड एंड इट इज द सिमिलर टू द मशीन कोड दैट नो प्रोसेसर विल अंडरस्टैंड. एट रन टाइम द ऑब्जेक्ट कोड इज कन्वर्टेड टू द मशीन कोड ऑफ द अंडरलाइंग प्लेटफॉर्म. मीन्स ऑब्जेक्ट कोड आर ऑल्सो लाइक अ मशीन कोड बट it is not completely converted. it will convert machine code in of the underlying platform. Java is both compiled and interpreted. We are telling that Java is compiler interpreter. How? To explicit relative advantages of compiler or interpreter, some programming languages like Java are both compiled and interpreted. The Java code itself is compiled into object code. There, Java code converted into object code itself. At runtime, the JVM interprets that object code into machine code of the target computer. So, Java compiled the high level code into object code. After that, JVM convert that object code into machine code by the help of interpreter. So Java is both compiled and interpreted language. Java Virtual Machine. What is JVM? Java Virtual Machine. The full form of JVM is Java Virtual Machine. It is the engine that drives the Java code. It is a railway engine. It is a like a railway engine. Railway engines drive the complete train, but JVM drives the Java code. Mostly in other programming languages, compiler produce code for a particular system, but Java compiler produce bytecode for virtual machine code for virtual machine. When we compile a Java program, then bytecode is generated. That time bytecode generated itself. That bytecode is the source code that can be used to run on any platform. That bytecode run on any platform. Bytecode is an intermediary language between Java source and the host system. It is also a intermediary language which can be understood by the Java source and the host system also. It is the medium which compiles Java code to bytecode, which gets interpreted on a different machine, and hence it makes it platform operating system independent. JVM works can be explained in the following manner. In first is reading bytecode. JVM first it will reading bytecode, then reading bytecode, then verifying bytecode also. After that, it verifying that type of bytecode, then it will link the code with the library classes. So after linking that, the program will understood by the system and it will convert it into machine code that will be understood by the computer system. Now in my next video, we will continue this chapter. Student, hope you all understood this chapter. If you have any problem, you can ask me through mail. Complete your work on time. And it is my advice. I repeat again and again that you will see complete video and you will read the chapter from your book also. Then you can solve all the home assignment and you can easily understand the topics which I have explained in this video. And you will complete your work easily. So complete your work on time, submit your work on time, because this assignment secure the marks also. So it is my advice, complete your work on time. Thank you. थैंक यू।